How to post this journal entry into Ledger. This is today's lecture. So we have five journal entries here. According to the transactions that we can see here, we have prepared all these journal entries. So now next step is very important, and how to create Ledger account. That I have already created this Ledger account empty format. So the one formula that we have set it here, when we see here the total of this one minus total of the credit side, that the balance, we can see it here. Even we can write it here, the balance, right? Balance carried forward. So carry forward means that this balance will goes to the next year, that will become the opening balance. So for example, this is the cash, and cash closing balance will be here. Let's say I have put this formula here. Why? The reason behind is to facilitate you that you need not to write, no need to write and calculate every time manually. Automatically it will be added, and whatever the amount that we put on this side, means on the credit side, it will be subtracted. Like 600 minus 100, 500 is automatically coming. If I change this figure to 250, let's see the difference. See, 350 is already here, that we can see it. When you click on this one, this formula that appears here, the sum of all these from here to here, and minus sum from all these figures that we put here to here. So this is the balance that we can see. And also this is known as the closing balance of this Ledger account. So it shows that in cash account, in cash, we have this balance. The bank balance, the closing balance will be here after when we do some transactions. So number of transactions that we have here, you can see. So first transaction is bank account debit to RJ's capital account. This is RJ is the owner of the business and started the food delivery or food restaurant on wheel. So he started a business with $10,000 by check and deposited that check in the bank. So now the bank account debit to RJ Capital. How to post into Ledger? To post into Ledger, the most important thing is that debit side should go on the debit and credit on the credit side. How to do this one? Look at the debit side, we have $10,000, and corresponding to the bank, go to bank and write $10,000 on the debit side. Okay, so I'm going to bank, and on the debit side, I'm going to write here $10,000. All right, this is the other element in the one journal entry is capital. RJ's capital account $10,000 on the credit side. Go to Ledger account and find where is the RJ capital you have prepared on the credit side, that you are going to write $10,000. Right, so this one transaction is completed, but the problem is that we are not able to recognize that the bank is here, figure is here, but there is no any particular. So in the particular that we want to write explanation and what this 10,000 is about, how it has come, right? So where it has gone. So some of the explanation is always required, so that even a layman should be able to understand easily. Okay, so what to do? In bank, write RJ's capital. In RJ's capital Ledger account, write bank. Okay, so in bank, I'm going to write here to RJ's capital account. So whenever that we are going to write here on this debit side, always write to. Whenever you're going to write on here credit side, always write by, right? Okay, so in bank RJ capital, in RJ capital by bank. So in this way, that one transaction is completed, right? We have posted one journal into Ledger. This is finished. If that you are able to post one transaction effectively with this technique, it means you will be able to post all the journal entries by yourself very easily. But for now, that I am going to complete it one by one. If I am going to explain the second, third, fourth, and fifth one, it means I am repeating the same process five times. Okay, so okay, no problem. That the second transaction I am going to post it. So second journal entry is cash is received by the business in the form of loan from Mr. Lee. So cash account debit and to Mr. Lee loans account. So I'm going to post this in the ledger. Click on the ledger, just write the cash account debit to Lee's account to Mr. Lee's loan, right? And Mr. Lee's loan is already created. Now just we are going to write here by, right? So the figure is same here, the figure that we're going to $15,000. So $15,000 that we are going to write it here. 15,000 here, debit side, and 15,000 on the credit side of Mr. Lee's loan. Right. Now we have $5,000 here. Cash account debit to Miss Mira's loan. Okay, so cash account debit to Miss Mira loan. We can write it here. Miss Mira on $5,000. And in Miss Mira loan, we will write by cash $5,000. It means this transaction is also completed. The third transaction is done. Now fourth one is a bank account debit to TD Bank loan account. Okay, so go so to the bank account.
Account was
and the bank account debit. Bank account debit. Right to TD Bank loan account. So bank on debit.
Excuse me, sir. Somebody is asking the question.
Okay. Yes, you can ask question. Yes.
Sir, you just posted 5,000 by cash on loan lease account. Can you put that in mirrors, please?
Yeah, I was saying the same thing.
5,000.
Yeah, I mean in Mira's account,
credit side.
Okay, just let me see. You're talking about Mira's loan, right? This one, the cash account debit to Mira's loan. So cash account debit to Mira's loan 5,000. In Mira's loan, that we need to write this one, right?
So this is Lee's account.
Yeah, this is in Mira's account.
The bottom one is Mira's, yeah.
Yes. Okay, so now that I have made some corrections here. Okay, so sometimes what happened that instead of writing somewhere that we write and put this in somewhere, so the answer will be same, but account will be disturbed, right? So that account will show that the from Mr. Lee that we need to pay this much amount, but actually this was not. All right, so this is the correction that we have done according to this entry. Next, we have bank account debit to TD Bank loan account. So here, bank account debit to TD Bank's loan account, we will write here. So here, the figure is here, $25,000. The loan is taken from the bank. Okay, so TD account, bank account debit to TD Bank's account. So in TD Bank loan account, we will write by bank. So here we are going to write by bank. Amount will remain same. That was the $25,000. So next we have the last journal entry, that is a truck account debit to bank. So now I am going to write here the truck account debit to bank. So go to truck account and write here the truck account debit to bank. The amount that we have paid for this one is $17,000. And here in bank account that we are going to write it here by. $17,000. So this is the benefit of writing a formula here. Automatically the total and balance is coming automatically in all the ledger account. So this is how the Microsoft Excel is really very useful for creating these kind of accounting exercises.